Hi, this is Mike with AskTractorMike.com. I'm standing today in a field of weeds, Johnson grass, actually almost as tall as I am, maybe a little bit taller. I need to be brush hogging today. And the reason I'm out here, I'm getting a lot of questions right now about brush hogs, or bush hogs, or rotary cutters. Bush hog's a brand name, but that's what a lot of us refer to them as. Or slashers, or toppers, depending on what part of the world you're in. And I'm going to talk in the next three videos about buying a rotary cutter. And give you some tips. And today's topic is three things that are often talked about in the sales process that I think are kind of just hype. I don't think they're things you really need to be that concerned about when you're picking out a rotary cutter. First thing I want to talk about is gearbox horsepower rating, or the size of the gearbox. And it's important to have good gearboxes on your machine, I'll give you that. But I witnessed a few years ago a company that had a really small gearbox on their heavier cutters, and they went from that to a gigantic gearbox. Well, what they actually went from was an American-built small gearbox that never failed to a gigantic gearbox that was made in China. And honestly, we had no problem with either one of them. Neither gearbox ever failed, but the one that was bigger was easier to sell. And it's important to remember when you're looking at a gearbox to get the size of the outside gearbox out of your mind. It's not what the size of the outside is that's important, it's what's inside that counts. And we need to worry about whether that will fail or not. Now, they rate gearboxes by the maximum amount of horsepower that they will take. And so you might see a 6-foot cutter with a 90 horse gearbox on it, and another one with a 70 horsepower gearbox on it. Should I buy the 90 horse gearbox? Well, that's up to you. If you've got a 30 horse tractor or 40 horse tractor and you're double or triple the capacity of the gearbox, then that's a moot point. That doesn't even matter. So the first thing I'm going to tell you, as long as the horsepower rating on that gearbox is more than your tractor, you're fine, and I wouldn't worry about it. The second item is right down that same road. It's gearbox warranty. Most of your cutters will have a year warranty on the deck and everything around it, possibly a 2-year, but most have a 1-year warranty. And then they'll put a really, really long warranty on the gearbox. But the fact of the matter is, the reality, if you keep that gearbox free of obstructions and you don't hit things that don't move, most any gearbox will last a long time. So you could really put a 20-year gearbox warranty on. But I see 4-year gearbox warranties, 5-year, 6-year gearbox warranty, and I wouldn't worry about that at all, because if a gearbox fails, 9 times out of 10, it's one of two or three things that have happened. Number one, if you ran it out of oil, or it got a lot of water in the oil and it loses its ability to lubricate the gear teeth, it can fail. That's not usually what happens. The obvious one is you hit something that doesn't move, like a well head or a culvert or something like that, and you take the gear teeth out. But your slip clutch or your shear pin should prevent that. The main thing that happens with most brush hog gearboxes that causes them to fail is you pick up an obstruction in the field. And I've talked about this a little bit, and it's really humorous to hear all the people comment about things they've run over in the field that gommed up under their brush hog. And if you don't get it out of there, like wire or twine can get up in that area where that seal is and take the seal out, and then your oil drains out, you lose lubrication, and your gearbox eventually fails. And that's what usually fails, and that is not covered under warranty. There's no way warranty is ever going to pay for that. And some of the things I've heard people run over, like bed springs and mattresses, and the one I heard that was the worst, and I can imagine this, is a carpet. Somebody ran over a carpet and it got gommed up under there and melted the fiber, the plastic part in the fibers, and just made a mess. And I can't even get my mind around how hard that must have been to get out. So I think you can throw gearbox warranty out the window. If it has a year warranty, you're fine. Any factory defect in a gearbox is likely going to occur right after you've started using the cutter in weeds like this. So having a 6-year gearbox warranty is probably not going to help you. If you come in year 6 and you torn the gearbox out, I'll bet you the supplier, doesn't matter what color is going to find a way of getting out of that warranty and not having to pay it. So if I don't think that's more hype than it is reality. And the last thing I'm going to tell you about with a rotary cutter, and a lot of people look at this, and I think it's somewhat important that you look at it, is blade tip speed. Blade tip speed is something we never ever looked at until maybe a decade ago when people started talking about how the faster the blades are moving, the prettier cut you're going to get. And that's true to a degree. But let's think about this just a second. With a rotary cutter, a brush hog, a topper, a slasher, you're usually, a lot of times, out in a woody field. You have, like in this area, it would be buckbrush or briar bushes or things that are woody. And you really don't want a high blade tip speed cutting them. You want to slash them off. You want to rough cut them so maybe rain will come down and rot will set in and kill the plants. So having a high blade tip speed will make a smooth cut on those woody materials, and that's not exactly what you want. Now, if you're only in grass and that's all you cut, a high blade tip speed will make a prettier cut. But then you have to ask yourself, if I'm only in grass and I want that pretty cut, do I want a cutter with blades that thick, or do I want a finish mower? And of course, you can get finish mowers, which are like lawn mowers that mount behind tractors or belly mowers under tractors to cut your field. If you want a really, really pretty look, a finish mower is the way to go, more than a rotary cutter or brush hog. But if you're going out in the woods and where there's woody plants, you'll destroy a finish mower. So blade tip speed to me is not something I'd be worried about on a rotary cutter. From a distance, all the cuts with the different rotaries, with the different blade tip speeds won't look that much different. You get up close to them, yeah, you can tell the difference. But I don't necessarily want that high blade tip speed because I'm trying to destroy some of these plants and hopefully won't get good regrowth on them. So those are three things that I think you really don't need to be looking at when you're buying a rotary cutter. Again, the next video is five things you definitely do need to look at that are important when selecting a rotary cutter. I appreciate you watching my videos. I'd be honored if you'd subscribe to my channel, like my Facebook page, and share this video with other tractor enthusiasts. And if you have questions or comments, put them down below. We'll try to get back with you. Thanks for watching.